Welcome to another video on Excel Pivot Table Playground. In this video, we're going to learn about grouping dates. In particular, we're going to be learning why group by month does not work and how we can make it work. Parallelly, the concepts that we will be covering are converting text to dates and automatic grouping of dates such that the problem is resolved, that is group by month not working. So let's look at the data first and insert a pivot table and see how that group by month is not working. So if I go to the data tab and I have perfectly looking data in the hiding and I have sales, which is again a numerical field. So if I insert a pivot table on this and say okay, and then I put transaction date to the rows area and sales to the values area, I'll be able to get the dates as I have in the data, and secondly I'll also get the number. But when I try to group the dates by right clicking and say group, you'll see it'll say cannot group that selection. So what's happening here? Even though in the previous series we have played around with dates such as this, in this particular example these dates are not grouping automatically. So what's the problem? For that we'll have to understand dates and then we'll come back to this problem again. So let's look at what's happening there. What date is zero? So if I just put zero here and then I want to format this into a date, you'll see I'll say control one, right? And then I'll go to the date format here and I'll choose, let's say 14th March 2012. So if I say okay, you'll see that I'll get 0 January 1900, which is the first date that the Excel is taking as a date. Which means if I do 1 here, it's 1st January 1900. And if I keep increasing the number to 2, to 3, you'll keep getting the dates. You'll keep getting the dates that are in increments of 1. So I'll just put this at 0 and leave it. So that's the date that Excel holds. Zero is basically 0 January 1900. And this is an interview question. In case you are interviewing for Excel, this will be one interview question. Next, we have text that looks like a date. So in this example, we have text, right, that looks like a date and that's why it's not grouping. So typically your date looks like this. And if it is aligned towards the left hand side, that means it's a text. And you will note that any date that is a number will typically be aligned to a right hand side. So which means that even though these two are looking like dates, they are not really dates. And how do I know that? In this example I showed you, right, if I convert this to a date, it's actually a number, right? So if I select these numbers and say control one and choose a number format or a general format, say okay, it should be ideally giving a number, but it's not, and hence we'll have to convert these two to a date format before we can use it, and then the pivot table will start working, right? We'll also have number that looks like a date, number that looks like a date, but they're different formats, right? And if you see, if I convert them into general, you'll see that you are getting the number that is behind the date, right? In this case, we don't have it, and hence that grouping is not working. And the similar way, you know, if you have a number and if you format it as a date, you'll see that it's going to be date like 20th May 2020, right? And similarly, the last example that I have is the date and time ramp. Now you might be wondering, if this is date, then how date and time is working? If you have a number along with the decimal, that means that it is date along with time assigned with it. So you can format it in two ways. You can do it only time formatting, or you can only do the date formatting, or you can do both together also. So if you go back to the formatting panel, control one, and then you choose a time format such as this, say okay, you'll get a time format. But if I want to have both date and time together, what I'll do is I'll come here and I'll take the custom format, the one that I have with this one here, and then I'll remove the X time that I have here, and I'm going to just say DD, MMM, and YY to basically say okay and get the date and time format here, right? So which means that if I change that to a general format, say okay, and if I change the decimal here to, let's say, something like this, 4, 5, 7, and say control one, go to the custom format and then choose the format that we recently chose, say okay, you'll see we'll get the time, which will be nothing but 20th May 2020, 10:58:05 a.m. Right? So the granular you go, the more seconds you're going to be influencing. Basically, that's what is happening with this particular date that we have in our data, right? It's actually text, but it's actually looking like a date. And hence, what we're going to do is we're going to first fix this, and then we're going to do the grouping by month. So to format this date into a date format, we're going to do a small trick. And the trick is basically removing the spaces that you have here, right? And if you have any other way, any other data that you want to format it, typically you want to select this and go to data, say text to column, keep going next, and then select date format and choose the date format you have to convert it into date, right? So for this example, I had put that space here, so I know that I have to remove that space. So what we'll do is we will basically trim this data, right? So I'm just going to say trim this to like this, and then what we'll do is we'll copy this column again by Control Shift and down, and then I'm going to take this one date here and then paste it here, right? I'll delete this. Now you'll see that this is still a date format because of this particular error. So what we can do here is that you can select this again here, and you'll have this small arrow where you can say, you know, convert to a date or something like that. So we can say convert access to, you know, 2020. So I'm going to say like this, and basically now it will take all the dates that you have here and it will convert it into the rightful date format. Now, if I insert the pivot table again, say okay, and choose transaction date in the rows area, and I take sales in the sales area, you'll see you are able to format the data in a way that the dates are again grouping, right? So if you expand it, you'll see that it is expanded by year, quarter, and month. And if you just want it only by month and year, so you're going to remove that, and you'll have the data grouped by month and year in pivot tables when the date is correctly formatted. So that's how you resolve the problem of group by month not working in pivot tables. It's by doing the right formatting to the date such that you can do the group by using pivot tables. Thank you for watching this video, guys. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel.